Hello everyone, my name is Phawx. Apologies for getting this video out to you so late. My initial plans were to have the aluminum heatsink in its own review video as well as a copper one, but unfortunately those initial tests didn't pan out. They weren't done correctly. My second mounting on the copper plate, as per the instructions of the developer himself, basically I had to use a better screwdriver, which he didn't tell me. The one that he gave me basically stripped, and I can show you an image of that later. But the other part that was valid is that you do have to use a lot of thermal paste, much more than is traditionally used in heatsinks themselves, like the traditional best practices. You have to use a considerable amount more, and I'll show you the differences that I use there. As it applies, this is going to be more of a more in-depth general review of everything, along with the cases themselves, heat and temperature, external temps as well. One of the reasons why I can't currently recommend the cases is because they don't have this SSD grounding contact that is present in the stock case. So that makes contact to the USB housing that you see right there. So one of the things that I would currently recommend is the current the copper heatsink itself does perform extremely well. Just for reference, I used Firmark at 12 watt on battery for 30 minutes, and that would get me to 85 degrees Celsius on the stock cooler. On the modified copper one, on my second mounting attempt, it went down to 71 degrees Celsius. So it's a 14 degrees Celsius temperature drop, which is huge. So right now, for sure, I can recommend the copper one. This is the amount of paste that I applied on my first copper heatsink, and that got to 75, 76 degrees Celsius, which he told me wasn't good. Additionally, you can see on the bottom right mounting point, that's labeled number one. That is pretty crucial. You need to screw that one in first, as well as moving the battery out of the way, either fully taking the battery out and kind of repositioning it. But you want to cross over on how you're mounting, but that number one point is very crucial. This is the amount of thermal paste that I used on the second mounting attempt, and I got basically a 6 degrees Celsius temp drop by just doing this and using a better screwdriver. So it's pretty huge what you can get just out of just putting more on. By the way, I am using Noctua NTH1 paste, and here you can see that this is the amount of flatness that you have to have. The next picture that you're going to be seeing here in a second, you can actually see, if you look right underneath the copper heat plate, you can see all of the excess thermal paste kind of just oozing out. Even though it's kind of gross, it is necessary. You will get better temps by doing it. Another thing to look at is you can see how closely pressed up against the battery this is. This is still my first go at it. Again, I kind of just moved it down without even really taking out the adhesive. I just kind of pushed it down until it scooted out of the way, about a millimeter out of the way. Here is the screwdriver that was included in the kit altogether, and basically three times, and the screwdriver itself had stripped away. So I really can't recommend using that screwdriver with the whole kit. I would really recommend getting a better screwdriver yourself. If you're pressed, you know, use this once and just hopefully you install it correctly the first time. It is a bit of a pain. These are the settings that I used on Firmark themselves, and then I just did GPU stress test. I didn't use any of the other ones. Basically all the settings on the left-hand side. The pictures you're about to see in sequence are 5 minutes at a clip. And you can just take a look at the CPU package temperature, and you can see that slowly going up. We basically stop at 71°C. For the most part, it's at 70 degrees Celsius, which is super, super impressive. But just because I recorded all that data and I had let it run for 50 minutes, this is what it looks like graphed out over 50 minutes. And you can see that it kind of like spikes up in and out, going to 71°C and whatnot. But this is basically the ceiling of what you should expect that copper heatsink to be doing for you. One of the things now, outside of internal temperatures, is how does that look on the external facing side? So this is the stock cooler and stock backplate, and you can see right in that red zone, the plastic on the back will get to 43 degrees Celsius. So what I did was I took the copper plate when I had good results, and then I use it in the ABS plate that he has, and you're seeing that right now. And these are the non-contact thermometer that I'm using here is reasonably accurate. I also had it pointing at boiling water, and it is like 99°C, 99.9°C. So it's within a degree of Celsius of error. It's basically, it's fine is what I'm telling you. And this is, for anyone that has been watching my channel previously, will know that I had pointed this at boiling water before to kind of calibrate and make sure that my thermometer was correct. And this is what ABS looks like. I apologize, I don't have a nice, like, FLIR, whatever thing it is, heat map that can produce good visuals. So it's a rather MS Paint-styled kind of heat zones, if you will. And then the winner, obviously, is the black nylon. This sucker is so ridiculously cool that it's kind of crazy. To the degree to how much of a difference the black nylon kind of resists heat in general is super, super impressive. So that, again, this is basically what that looks like on black nylon. Now, the unfortunate bit is that I can't really recommend these cases just yet. And I can't really make any super conclusions just yet because there's an updated heatsink coming to me and there are updated cases still coming to me. So this is kind of an intermediary review of what is there. The good news is that I can fully comment on the copper heatsink itself, but I would say with the caveat that you should Dremel out the internals of your stock case. Now, noise is another thing. I have an analog meter, and at full tilt, at full RPM, they make exactly the same amount of noise, both at point blank range, 6 inches, 3 inches, and 2 feet away. Both of them make the exact same amount of noise. However, the idle RPM is what is different, and that I can let you listen to right now. So this is the stock fan idle noise. And this is the custom mod idle noise. And at that point, you can actually hear the lower RPM making a big difference on the custom fan. Now, as it applies to weights, when we take a look at the stock case, that is 459 grams. The stock bottom case is 32 grams, and the stock heatsink is 28 grams. And those are just like baseline weights, just so that you guys can have them, and you can kind of understand what the difference is between the copper, aluminum, and stock. The stock case plus aluminum is 461 grams, the ABS plus aluminum is 463 grams, and the nylon plus aluminum is 454 grams. So the aluminum one, depending on the case, you're not going to really feel a large difference, even though that the nylon is considerably less weight than the other cases. It doesn't really amount to much when everything is fully packaged together with the SSD and the SSD case cover itself. And then the copper weights themselves. So you have the stock case plus copper is 515 grams, the ABS plus copper at 517 grams, and then the nylon plus copper at 507 grams. You're basically looking at a 10% increase, 12% increase in weight. I don't really notice it. When I'm holding it and moving around, I don't really notice it at all. So basically, the weight of it, don't be concerned about it at all. It's nothing to even really think about. But those are the numbers for them. All right, so in conclusion, what can we gather from all of this? Number one, the weight of the copper heatsink is not going to be something that I think you will even notice at all. It is 12% heavier, but even with the stock case itself, I don't think that you're actually going to notice anything in terms of the weight of it. If that was a detriment to you, thinking, oh, it's, you know, going to be adding 60 grams, 50 grams, I really wouldn't even consider it. It's not even anything to even bother thinking about. Additionally, because the price difference between the aluminum block and the copper block on Indiegogo is so small, that for sure I would just say just get the copper block. I'm not really seeing any real reason to get the aluminum. I just don't see it. I will still test the aluminum block because out of my own curiosity. And I can't honestly recommend any of the cases at the moment. So if you're on the fence, basically the only reason that you should be getting these heatsinks at all is if you want to be running your system at 12 watts or greater. If you are a person that is happy at 8.25 watt, I don't really see the need to get this thing. But if you want to have, you know, the absolute best consistent performance out of your GPD Win 2, yes, 100% get the copper heatsink block. It is a little temperamental to install. It does take some time. You will have to move the battery out of the position a little. There's some work that you have to do. You have to use a lot of paste. It's not going to be an easy gain, and you're going to have to work at it. The other problem is that the mounting points on the GPD Win 2 itself, if you just keep on screwing at them and kind of replacing it, eventually you might break it. So please be careful when you're replacing the heatsink on there. Only get this heatsink if you want to push your machine as far as it possibly can go. 100% at 12 watt at 70 degrees Celsius, that is amazing results. And that's something that I got myself. The creator self is saying that you can get even better. Perhaps you can with better thermal paste. I'm just telling you what I got, and my results are frankly amazing. So that's it. Hopefully I'll be able to get more stuff in the updated case and the updated composite heatsink with the aluminum copper together, and I can test that. But until then, right now, the only thing that I can recommend is the copper heatsink only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good one.